MySQL. So is it a application software or system software, Meenakshi? Very good. It's an application software because we are using it for some purpose. So it's not like your operating system, MySQL. And the last previous class we were telling about, we were seeing the different types of, the brief history of MySQL. Isn't it? Brief history of MySQL. So the MySQL name got generated from the inventor's daughter's name. The inventor's daughter's name is My. That's why that SQL is a structured query language that we use in MySQL. So that is how. And what is the logo? Which bird it is, Vithur?
Dolphin.
It's a dolphin. Okay, what is the dolphin's name, Meenakshi? You have a pop singer with that name? Somewhat similar name, pop singer, isn't it? Who's that pop singer? Evelyn. No idea. Nevin.
Shakila, right?
Shakila. Okay. Okay. So that is a dolphin's name. Okay. So that's all about the brief history. Then we will see what are the different advantages, why we use the features of MySQL. Okay. So it's a combination of MySQL server instance and MySQL database. So we don't have to worry about what is this instance and all. No. So we can leave that first statement as not required for you. This is the main point. It operates using client server architecture. So you can start, you can start writing from the second point. That is, it uses a client server architecture. Client server architecture. So who's the client? Who is the client? Anthony, who is the client? Lydia, who's the client? The person who is getting the services from someone, that person is called as a client, isn't it? So when you are using your system, you are the client. When you open Facebook, you are the client and as a human being, and through which software we are communicating, so that you are Facebook. So you can say that Facebook is a client software. And which is, who is the server? So when you type your user ID and password, and when you click on sign in button, the signals, the data will go to the server machine and it will be checked, and the server will be giving the, what are the different conditions that after the checking the different username and password, whether it's right or wrong, that appropriate, with appropriate things, the result will be sent back to the client software. Then the client software will display the result to us. That is, your ID, password, or user name is incorrect. Isn't it? Sometimes you used to see in that way. So who's a client? The client who is getting the service from the server machine. So who's a server? Who serves? Who serves is called a server machine. So this MySQL, it is working with a client server architecture. Through the client, we will request the database, and the database as a client, it will give us the information back based on the questions that you are sending to the database. So that is why it is called as client server architecture. Okay. So server runs on the machine containing the database. You know that when you create a Facebook account or Instagram account, your actual saving, actual data will be saved somewhere in a database in the server, isn't it? It's not saved in your system, isn't it, Nevin? It will be saved somewhere. It's not saved in your local system. It will be saved somewhere. So that machine is called a server machine. So where the, your database is situated. Okay, so the server runs on the machine containing the database. And who is the client? Since we are requesting for Instagram account, so we will, when you take Instagram account in your mobile, you can see the latest updations. So from where these latest updations are coming from? It's coming from the server machine. So whoever you followed, their updates will come first. So the client connects to the server over the network, through the internet, through the network, the client communicates. When you open Instagram, if it is automatically logged in, then automatically the server, the Instagram software is sending the message, sending a request to the server machine. Server will be sending the request. After processing the request, it will be sending back with the recent updates. And Instagram will be showing you the recent updates. So it is a client-server mechanism. So that's why it is called, that type of architecture is called as client-server architecture. The data will be stored in the database and there will be a server program for processing it. And there will be client program which will be requesting for the data, requesting the different questions. You can ask questions. Okay, it is a multi-user database system. So a single person. So my question is, you can use Facebook in your mobile. At the same time, you can open it in your laptop. At the same time, you can open it in a tablet, isn't it? So what is happening there? So all these are, when you open in any machine, any device, it will be taking the data from a single database, isn't it? It's from a single database. So it is a multi-user data. So MySQL. So I'm not telling that every Instagram all are using MySQL softwares. Basically all RDBMS softwares are, it is multi-user. Multi-user means same database can be accessed by different people. That's called multi-user. Several users can access the database simultaneously. I have sent this PDF to your WhatsApp group. Hope you have got it. Simultaneously, you can access. Now, who's a server? What is a server? A listens for client request and access the database and provide the requested information to the client. That particular machine, or it can be a program, it can be software or a hardware, it's called as a server. Server always doesn't mean it is a software. It can be hardware, it's a software. Okay, so the client will be a program or another software that connects to MySQL server and sends the request. That is important. It is sending the request. It is listens for the client and provide the requested information. That's the difference. Request information here, sends the request. This is provide the request information to the client. After processing it, this is sends a request to the server machine. Okay, you can make it as a MySQL, it can be a MySQL prompt or just a moment. Can you tell me some examples of a front-end softwares? I have told you before. Front-end softwares. Vithur. Front-end softwares, where you are interacting with the system, is already there in the screen. Java, Python. We can connect Python to MySQL. Front-end, Python is front-end, MySQL is back-end. Java is front-end, MySQL is back-end. VB is front-end, MySQL is back-end. VC++, we can use any front-end software as a client. So these are called client, and MySQL will be your server machine. Okay, so it follows a client-server architecture. So what is the architecture supported by MySQL, Reina? Architecture supported by MySQL is? Bazel.
Ma'am, it runs on the machine containing database.
No. You told me to repeat? Or you were telling the answer? It's not clear. Once again. Bazel.
Runs on the machine containing database.
My question is, what is the type of architecture it supports? What is the architecture used by MySQL? Mohammed Irfan.
Yes, ma'am.
Architecture supported by MySQL. If you are not listening in the class, then why I am taking all this for you? Video is off, network issue, it's okay. But you have to listen in the class properly. And once I ask the question, you are asking me, repeat it. Because you are doing something else. Elvina.
Client-server architecture.
Client-server architecture. And basically, what is a client? Did you write the notes when I was explaining this? Did you write the notes, Bazel?
Yes, ma'am.
Then tell me, what is a client?
It connects to a server or a network.
That's all. Pavitra. Got stuck. Pavitra. What is a server? Pavitra. Donna, what is a server?
It sends requests to the server and also receives the response.
Receives the response?
Of the server.
Of the server. My question is, what is a server? You are telling me the definition of client.
Or it listens for client.
Listen in the class, children. So listen carefully. Bazel, Mohammed Irfan, I will ask you questions. Pavitra, everyone, especially two of you. So now the different features of MySQL. It runs very fast. When you compare with other RDBMS softwares, it runs very fast. It is easy to use. Free, of course, it's open source software. It's freely download and freely you can use. That's why I told you to download from net. Meenakshi, is your installation over? Meenakshi? Meenakshi. Meenakshi is here. Meenakshi, I can't hear you, Meenakshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Installation is over. Okay. It supports query language. So that I will tell you what is it. It supports SQL. Portability. Portability means just take it in a flash drive or you send it to a drive and you can use it in some other system. Say for example, Navin has a Macintosh, isn't it, Navin?
Yes, ma'am.
So it will run in both Macintosh and Windows anywhere. It's portable. It's portable. You can take it from one place. One place means one machine which has a different architecture to other machine which has a different architecture. It can run on any platform. Here the platform means the operating system. It will run in any operating system. Then it supports various data types like we have studied for in Python, different data types. In Python, what are the different data types? Basil, the different data types of Python. No idea. Mohammed Irfan, the different data types.
Floating point numbers.
Hmm.
Complex numbers.
Hmm.
Strings.
Hmm.
Integers.
Hmm. Tuple. List. Dictionary. Set. These are the different data types. Good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so these are the different data types used in Python. The same way, MySQL supports different data types like numbers, integers, float, character. There is a different data type called char, C-H-A-R, the short form of character, char data type. Then one extra data type that is date data type, time data type. Two more extra data types are there supported by MySQL. So it supports lots of data types. Now, you don't have to study this. Now, this is how you will install it. So those who have installed it, you will come to know that when you search in programs and files, you have to search for MySQL command line client. Okay. And just drag it and you can drop it in your taskbar so that later you can use it or right click and you can send to desktop as a shortcut, those who are having laptop or PC. So this is the thing that you have to search. This is your client software, client. So here we are working as a client. The server means it will be the whatever tables we are creating that will be saved in the database. So it will act as a server. In both things are in the same software. So this is how it will look like. So Meenakshi, you have given a password, right?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. So it will work in that way. So you can give a password and you will get a prompt. This is called a prompt. You will get a prompt in this way. If you want to exit, you can close directly using mouse, or you can write exit or quit. Clear? So we will be working in this black background window. Now, share screen is on. Meenakshi, you can share the screen. Meenakshi? Meenakshi is here? Yes. No. What about you, Nevin? Have you installed it? No.
I'll just go right now. I opened the thing.
Did you find out that MySQL command client somewhere?
It is something else, but it opened and there are codes.
What about others? Those are using Windows operating system. Vidur, Pavitra, Hana, Shadeth. Nobody installed it. Evelyn, did you install it? Evelyn?
No, ma'am.
No, not that. MySQL, no. Command client, I need to get. Evelyn?
No, ma'am.
So nobody installed it. So I will show it here. Then. Here you just type for. What do you need to type, Basil?
MySQL.
See, you can see MySQL command line client. Okay. So click on that. I forgot the password. Let me try. I think it's computer. I have given. Yes. Can see this window. So the password I have given. So it came in this way. MySQL prompt, it is called MySQL prompt. And you can write quit, type quit, you can quit. Clear, that's how it works, that how you start MySQL. So you need to get a window in the start button, you need to get a icon as MySQL command client. That clear? Vithur, Reina? Okay, so you have to install. Everyone should install it, those who are having laptop or PCs. You can't easily install it in this way in your tablet or mobile phone. Okay. Now let's see what is SQL. What is the full form of SQL, Basil? What is the full form of SQL, Atul? What's the full form of SQL, Sharath? Video is not on and there is no response. So what should I understand from this?
Who's telling? Okay. Query language.
What's your video?
Ma'am, I have owned it and I am having a network instability.
Did you turn on it? I don't think so.
No, ma'am. I owned it in the beginning of the class. It gets turned
beginning
off
of the between. Class. Okay. All right. Okay. So the question to the missing students. Sharath, are you there, Sharath? Sharath.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the full form of SQL? Where did you go, Sharath, in this few seconds? Huh? Tell me the truth. Are you feeling hungry?
I went to drink some water.
Louder, louder. What is the full form of SQL?
System management. I don't know, man. I forgot.
Vithur.
Structured query language.
What is this, Sharath? Structured query language. Structured query language. So what is it? It's a language we use to write the commands in order to create the table, in order to delete from the table, in order to create a database, we use this language. like our Python language. Python is a different type of language. It's a high level language. Here it is, in order to write the different programs, in order to write the commands, you use a common language that is called structured query language. The same language is, it is a standard for all the RDBMS, whether it is MySQL, Oracle, Microsoft Access, any backend softwares, they are using a single common language that is, Grishma, that is? That is? Mohammed Irfan?
Yes, ma'am.
That is? No. That is, Sharath?
SQL.
SQL, very good. Mohammed Irfan, listen in the class.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, structured query language. So if, when you study any language, if you want to study English language or if you want to study Python language, you have to study the basics of that language, isn't it? The same way, in order to study SQL language, why it is called structured query language? Because whatever we are sending is a query, is a question to the database. That's why it's called structured query language. It has a structure. That is why it is almost same as your English language. It's not like Python language. Okay, so we need to study the basics. What are the different alphabets used? Okay, what are the different valid things you can use in this language? So we are going to study a new language, that is structured query language. Okay, so write the heading as SQL. SQL stands for, it is not structured query language, structured query language. Then why we use this? It is used only in relational databases. What is a relational database, Atul? What is a relational database, Atul? Elvina, what is a relational database?
Another name for table.
Okay, so if a database uses tables for storing data, then that kind of databases are called as relational databases. So all the relational databases use one and only one language, that is SQL. It is used to create and operate on relational databases, okay? Then MySQL also use, since it's a relational database, is also use SQL. It is a standard language used by all the database software vendors. It is pronounced as SQL. Even though it is SQL, it is pronounced as SQL. Original version was developed, this is a history, IBM's Almaden Research Center. 2008, the latest version is released. It's a standard language, it's a history. From this SQL, this particular name came, MySQL. So we'll pronounce it as SQL. SQL. Clear? Atul? So there are slight changes in this particular page. First one is the different SQL, the structured query language is classified into, first one, DAL, same. DML, DCL, TCL. DDL, DML, DCL, TCL. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. DCL stands for Data Control Language. After that, I will ask you. Control Language. TCL, Transaction Control Language. DDL, Data Definition Language. DML, Data Manipulation Language. DCL, Data Control Language. TCL, Transaction Control Language. Okay, so next topic we will take in the next class. Okay, till 1 o'clock, right? The classes. So, Muhammad Irfan, tell me, what are the different SQL categories? Muhammad Irfan. Muhammad Irfan. Basil.
I'm DDL, DML, DCL, and TCL.
Very good. Full form of DDL. Reina.
Data Definition Language.
Grishma. DML.
Data Manipulation.
Pavitra stuck. Meghna. TCL.
Transaction Control Language.
Donna, DCL.
Data Control Language.
Okay, that's all for today. We'll see the other things in the next class. I have told someone to explain the concepts, isn't it? Who was that, Vithur? Who was that?
Ma'am.
Who was that? Huh?
I think from me.
I have told someone to explain the concept. Who was that, Meghna? Meghna is smiling. Who was that?
Ma'am.
Ah, you only. Then why you did not tell me it before?
No, I was saying yes, ma'am.
So it's okay. We can say in the next class. Okay. So no, remind
only
me.
Only 4 in Kino.
Hmm?
Only 4 in Kino.
Yes. Now you can explain the next class. Okay. Only 4 in Kino. Okay then. Bye.